إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة، وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهديه وسار على سنته إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي أولاً بتقوى الله تعالى وطاعته، ولزوم أوامره وكثرة مخافته، فإنها شعار المؤمنين ودثار المتقين، ووصية الله فيه وفيكم أجمعين. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم، يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت، وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها، وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. إخوتي في الله، جاء في الحديث الصحيح في صحيح مسلم الذي رواه أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال: بدأ الإسلام غريبا وسيعود غريبا كما بدأ، فطوبى للغرباء. وفي رواية قيل: يا رسول الله، من هم الغرباء؟ فطوبى للغرباء. قيل: يا رسول الله، من هم الغرباء؟ قال: هم الذين يصلحون إذا فسد الناس. هذا الزمن إخواني الأحبة، زمن الغرباء، هو نفسه في مقابله حينما يكون هناك غرباء يصلحون إذا فسد الناس، هو نفسه في المقابل زمن الرويبضات الذي ذكرناه في خطب أخرى سابقة. قيل: وما الرويبض يا رسول الله؟ قال: الرجل التافه يتحدث في أمور العامة. هو نفسه إخواني الأحبة زمن الغثاء، كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: تتداعى عليكم الأمم كما تتداعى الأكلة إلى قصعتها. قيل: أو من قلة نحن يومئذ يا رسول الله؟ قال: لا، بل أنتم يومئذ كثير، ولكنكم غثاء كغثاء السيل. هو نفسه إخواني الأحبة زمن الاتباع الأعمى، حين قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الصحيح: لتتبعن سنن من قبلكم حذو القذة بالقذة، حتى لو دخلوا جحر ضب لدخلتموه وراءهم. وفي رواية قيل: النصارى واليهود، أو قال: ومن غيرهم، يعني بما معناه أي أنهم النصارى واليهود، حتى لو دخلوا جحر ضب لدخلتموه وراءهم، أي أن الاتباع الأعمى في الأمور التي ليس فيها خير، وإنما في الأمور التي فيها خير نحن مطالبون، بل سماها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بالحكمة: والحكمة ضالة المؤمن، أن وجدها فهو أحق بها. لكن حينما تتبع الأمة سفاسف الأمور عند الأقوام الآخرين وعند الأمم الأخرى، هذا ما يصفه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: حتى لو دخلوا جحر ضب لدخلتموه وراءهم. هذا الزمن إخواني الأحبة، كما قلت، هو زمن يتميز فيه الأمة عن غيرها من الأمم أنها لا تموت، يعني تمرض ولكنها تستطيع متى أرادت أن تعود إلى القيادة وإلى قيادة البشرية كما أرادها الله عز وجل: وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسطا لتكونوا شهداء على الناس ويكون الرسول عليكم شهيدا. قضية معروفة، ليس هناك يأس، ولكن في المقابل ليس هناك تمني، ليس هناك تمني، كما قلت وكما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: العاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله الأماني. لا، نعم هذه الأمة لا تعرف شيء اسمه اليأس، ولكن يجب أن من دفع الثمن حتى تعود إلى القيادة. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: تركت فيكم ما إن تمسكتم به لن تضلوا بعدي أبدا، كتاب الله وسنتي. طريق العودة دائما موجود حتى في أحلك الأمور وفي أحلك الأوقات وأشدها ضيق. الله عز وجل دائما يعد بأن الطريق للعودة مفتوح، وأن العبد إذا ما فعل خطوة أن الله عز وجل يتقدم إليه خطوتين، شبر ذراع، يأتي مشي، يأتي رسول الله عز وجل إليه هرولة. وهذا حال الأمة متى أرادت أن تعود، الطريق مفتوح. في الحديث الصحيح إخوان الأحبة الذي رواه ابن عمر عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول: إذا تبايعتم بالعينة وأخذتم أذناب البقر ورضيتم بالزرع وتركتم الجهاد سلط الله عليكم ذلا. هل الطريق مفتوح للعودة؟ قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: لا ينزعه، أي الذل والهوان، حتى ترجعوا إلى دينكم. العينة إخوان الأحبة نوع من أنواع الربا، يعني ربا النسيء اللي هو المحرم واضح وصريح، تقول لواحد أعطيك 9000 ترجع ليهم بعد سنة 10000. بعض المسلمين يأخذوا بنفس الالتفاف والالتواء الذي يفعله بني إسرائيل حينما أمرهم الله عز وجل بأن لا يصطادوا في يوم السبت. ماذا فعلوا؟ وضعوا شباكهم يوم الجمعة ولموا السمك يوم الأحد. فنفس الشيء بعض المسلمين إيش يعمل؟ يروح يبيع السيارة لواحد بالأجل 10000. طبعا ما يعطي شيء لأنه بالأجل بعد سنة، يعطي 10000، لكن إيش يسوي؟ مباشرة في نفس اليوم أو بعد يوم يشتريها منه 9000. يعني إيش معناتها؟ أعطاه 9000 دولار أو دينار وهو سيردها بعد سنة 10000. يلف. فيقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم: إذا تبايعتم بالعينة وأخذتم أذناب البقر ورضيتم بالزرع، يعني وراء البقر من شان الحرث، ورضيتم بالزرع وأشغلكم عن الدعوة إلى الله عز وجل وعن الآخرة وعن البذل لهذا الدين وعن الجهاد في سبيل الله وتركتم الجهاد سلط الله عليكم ذلا لا ينزعه حتى ترجعوا إلى دينكم. اللهم اجعلنا الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لكم فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين. الحمد لله كما أمر، والصلاة والسلام على خير البشر محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه الميامين الغرر. ما اتصلت عين بنظر وأذن بخبر وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Dear brothers and sisters, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is his servant and his messenger. Peace be upon him and upon all the messengers of Allah from the time of Adam through Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, and the seal of the prophets, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon all of them. Dear brothers and sisters, in the authentic hadith narrated in Sahih Muslim by Abu Huraira radiallahu anh, may Allah be pleased with him, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, بَدَأَ الْإِسْلَامُ غَرِيبًا وَسَيَعُودُ غَرِيبًا كما بدأ فطوبى للغرباء. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Islam started, when it started as something that is strange, something that's not familiar to the people, something that shocked the people. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, قولوا لا إله إلا الله تفلحوا, say لا إله إلا الله, you will be successful, what was the response? تبا لك, ألهذا جمعتنا؟ They insulted the Prophet ﷺ. Did you call us and gather us for such kind of a call? That is so strange to their ears. بَدَأَ الْإِسْلَامُ غَرِيبًا وَسَيَعُودُ غَرِيبًا. One day it's going to come back also strange among the people. those who are attaching and adhering to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will look at them and you will say, these are extremists. These are fanatics. These are weirds. These are nerds. These are strange people. They don't belong to our time. فَطُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَاء. But what a glad news, the Prophet ﷺ said, for so such people. الْغُرَبَاء, strangers. In another narrations, the companions asked the Prophet ﷺ, مَنْ هُمُ الْغُرَبَاء? Who are those you are calling or referring to, O Prophet of Allah, as غُرَبَاء, strangers? The Prophet ﷺ said, الَّذِينَ يُصْلِحُونَ إِذَا فَسَدَ النَّاسِ. Those who do something good, who try to amend the corruption when the rest of the people are living in mischief and in corruption. Those are the ghuraba. And whenever you are talking about the time of the ghuraba, dear brothers and sisters, those who are steadfast in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when everyone else is turning their back to the deen, there has to be the same time when the corruption is increasing. The time of Ar-Ruwaybida that the Prophet ﷺ mentioned in another hadith. And when they ask him, who is Ar-Ruwaybida? That's on the other extreme. The Prophet ﷺ said, those trivial people who are leading and speaking in the name of the public. That will be the time of Ar-Ruwaybida. This is the same time of the time of al-ghutha, the scum, the all this dirt that float on the surface of the ocean. When the Prophet ﷺ said that all the nations will come together in order to divide you and take you as pieces to eat you, exactly as the gathered people around a dish of food, everyone trying to take a piece of it. They asked the Prophet ﷺ, is it because we are few at that time and the enemy are so much, so many? The Prophet ﷺ said, no. You will be so many, but you will be the time of al-ghutha, ka-ghutha is-sail. That the foam that comes on the top of the surface that has no roots whatsoever and no value. This is the same time, dear brothers and sisters, of the blind following of the others, in which the Prophet ﷺ said, you are gonna follow blindly the steps of the nations before you, to the point that if they will enter the hole of a lizard, you will enter it behind them. He didn't say if you enter the top of a mountain, you will follow them, because that is the hikmah. And we as Muslims required to follow the hikmah, the wisdom, no matter where it comes from. Muslim or non-Muslim, it is our property and that we have to compete with it. But the Prophet ﷺ said, to the point that when they enter the hole of a lizard, a dark hole means you are following them in the worst of what they have, not on the best of what they contribute to the civilization. That's all is the same time, dear brothers and sisters, described by the Prophet ﷺ in several ahadith, targeting and pointing towards certain angles of this time. But why? Why we are going through this time is something that need to be asked about, and we have to reflect on it. The nice thing about this ummah, dear brothers and sisters, is that this ummah, as we said before, will never perish, will never be destroyed completely. And the way back out to the victory and to leadership is always open. In so many verses in the Quran, in so many ahadith, the door is wide open for the ummah to come back to leadership. But if they pay the price for it, not just only wishes. When the Prophet ﷺ said, الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت. The true wise person is the one who will put himself, will hold himself accounted for, accountable, and will be questioning himself and will work for the next day or the hereafter. والعاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله. The weakness, the helpless is the one who sit down, relax, keep wishing while he is following his own whims and desires and keep wishing that, oh, one day I will come back and I will be in the leadership. It's not going to happen. When you pay the price, yes, you will. The Prophet ﷺ made it so clear in authentic hadiths. The Prophet ﷺ said, I left with you two things. If you adhere to them, you will never go astray. And they are always here. They are among us. If we live them, if we embrace them, if we live according to them, we will always come back. The Prophet ﷺ said, Kitab Allahi wa Sunnati, the book of Allah and my Sunnah. We have the door open, dear brothers and sisters. We never lose hope, but we have to work for it to make a change. When the Prophet ﷺ said in another authentic hadith, which is narrated by Ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, he said that I heard the Prophet ﷺ saying, إذا تبايعتم بالعينة, that if you are dealing with usury and interest, وأخذتم أذناب البقر ورضيتم بالزرع, and you start following the back or the using, living behind the cows, and this is an expression that you only got busy with planting the land and agricultures, وَرَضِيتُمْ بِالزَّرْعِ, and you accepted this as a way of life and took you away from your main mission in this life, which is to give victory to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتَرَكْتُمُ الْجِهَادِ, and you left striving for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all forms of jihad. Whether jihad with your wealth, jihad with yourself, jihad with the word, jihad with the da'wah, if you leave all of that and the worldly issues and temptation becomes your main goal in this life, what the Prophet ﷺ said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will strike you with complete humiliation among the other nations. You will be in the tail of the other nations. But the door is not closed, dear brothers and sisters. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, حَتَّى تَرْجِعُوا إِلَىٰ دِينِكُمْ, until you come back to your deen, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change your status. إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغير ما بأنفسهم. We did talk about those obstacles, dear brothers and sisters, that the ummah is going through. That is making us right now in the time of Ar-Ruwaybida, in the time of Al-Ghuraba, in the time of Al-Ghutha, and in the time of the blind following of the others. There is always solution, but only when we are able to diagnose the problem and the disease. We talked about those, dear brothers and sisters, the first obstacle we mentioned in the previous khutbah, which is relying on the past, relying on the wishes, having tawakkul instead of tawakkul, relying that we have the name Islam without any actions, relying on the glad tidings, al-mubashirat, that Islam will be victorious, but without paying the price. That was one of the main diseases that the ummah was suffering from, and we talked about it. And today, inshallah, I would like to talk about one more item regarding those obstacles that are holding the Ummah down. And that is the issue of, which is always going back, even if it is behavior issue and problem, but always look for the roots of it, it will be right here. The thaqafa, the culture. That is what is directing and controlling all of those weaknesses that we see as symptoms. And today, inshallah, I would like to talk about that in many ways of our life and the way we run our affairs, we always move from individualism rather than as a group and as an ummah. In many aspects, it's always about me, not us. And that is a problem, dear brothers and sisters, because it is affecting our discipline, it's affecting our order and organization, and it is making us completely go the other direction. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold to the robe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all together and don't differ between each among each other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say unite and don't differ. Don't say that worry about the numbers but don't differ. That's not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He referred to the enemy, He said, تَحْسَبُهُمْ جَمِيعًا. You think they are all together. وَقُلُوبُهُمْ شَتَّى. But their hearts are apart from each other. We are not talking about the outside picture, the outside shell, dear brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ. Not in any other robe, but in the robe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we can move as with coordination all of our efforts, and we understand that we support each other, كالبنيان المرصوص, like one body. But if we look at ourselves that we are only small entities, each one by itself, then we say, okay, whatever I do, it's only gonna benefit me or it's gonna only hurt me. But in reality, it's hurting the whole body. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. There are so many ways you can look at the scale of communities, scale of an ummah. You will have always those problems. Even in our own small community, dear brothers and sisters, you can see that in so many ways. During Ramadan, when everybody let their kids away and without any discipline. When you see the dirt everywhere and you always think of the other one, he is the one who is going to take and remove that dirt from the road. When you have a fight outside because of a parking lot, when the people are, or the leadership, or those people who are in charge, try to ask you to stick by the rules, and it becomes not about rules or organization that will benefit all, but it becomes a personal ego. He is telling me what to do. Completely take it completely out of context and completely out of the spirit of the jama'ah, the spirit of the ummah. So many ways, dear brothers and sisters. To the point that we start saying it so clearly. Oh, why when we look at the others, when they are in the street, when they are in the churches, when they are in this and this and that, their kids are well disciplined, but only our kids. And we start comparing ourselves to the others. Why? What is the problem? When we as an ummah, the most supposed to be the most disciplined ummah. You can stand up and stand in the prayers, but you can't dare to move one step before the imam. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching you in this and teaching all of us.
Discipline and organization, you stand in one line. Crooked lines are not blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shoulder to shoulder, facing one qibla, one unity. Moving with the imam after he says Allahu Akbar. We do this 5 times a day, teaching us. And yet, when we come outside of our prayers, it does not reflect. That's a problem. I remember when I was young, and a friend of my father, he was telling us a story and he was laughing. He said that when he traveled to Germany, in the road, in the highway, he threw the can that he was drinking or the water bottle after he finished, he threw it from the window. He said that immediately a helicopter comes from above and catch him and give him a fine. He throw it just a bottle from the window, which is for them, according to the culture that it became thaqafa of the community, this is a crime that need to be fined. But when he was telling us the story, he was telling it and he was laughing. Look to the others, they don't, unfortunately, we don't do this and that. And he is assuming that the others need to hear this story, not that he need to learn from it. We always expect the others. When sometimes I give a khutbah, I wish that one brother will come to me and say, my brother, I learned from it. You have made me change myself. I do have and realize this weakness in me personally. No, it's always a brother will come. Many brothers will come and say, MashaAllah, Jazakallah khair for reminding the community, for reminding the others, for this, as if it is only for the others. And when there is a problem between two groups of Muslims and I address the problem as an issue, both of groups comes to me individually and telling me, MashaAllah, Jazakallah khair for telling those, the other group about that. When I, in fact, I was mentioning for everyone, including both groups, not for one group against the other. But it is that problem, dear brothers and sisters, when we always assume it is for the others. So many ways that we can look at it. We can live as one community, we can be organized, we can be disciplined, and we can achieve a lot. Or we can be separated. Everyone's always only worried about themselves, and our efforts, even if they are good efforts, will be scattered with no real effect, influence, or results. One time, the Prophet ﷺ sent a group of Muslims to go into a battle with one of the tribes. Those group, when they arrived to there, they were overwhelmed with the number of the tribe that they are going to face them in and fight with them. So they had disagreements among each other. One group said, we should fight because that's what the Prophet ﷺ sent us for. In this mission, we have to complete it. The other group said, no, there is another tribe next to us that have a good treatment, alignment, and allies of us. So maybe we should go and seek refuge with them. The third group, they said, no, we should go back to the Prophet ﷺ and ask him. So the third group went back to the Prophet ﷺ. When they arrived to Medina, they came to the Prophet ﷺ and they said to the Prophet ﷺ, one half or one third went and battled, the other went to such and such a tribe and seek refuge in them, with them, and we came back to ask you, O Prophet of Allah, which of the decisions that we need to do? Do you know what the Prophet ﷺ said? He did not even address the disagreements among them. Oh, you are right. No, that are right. No, the third group are right. No, the Prophet said, سَلْتُكُمْ جَمِيعًا وَرَجَعْتُمْ إِلَيَّ مُتَفَرِّقِينَ I sent you as a one team and you are coming back to me divided. The problem is that spirit of being as one team should be the one that will move us, and that's what will make us make a difference. When the people of Quraysh, they put a sanction against Bani Hashim, the family, the tribe of the Prophet ﷺ, and all the companions who accepted Islam. 3 years of sanctions, dear brothers and sisters. Very tight. No buying, no selling, no marriage, nothing. No interaction with them. And everybody know, if you read what was the situation and the status of the Muslims and the Bani Hashim in that valley of Abu Talib. So how did this sanction and this boycott was broken? That was written in a piece of paper stamped inside the Kaaba. It started with one person, dear brothers and sisters. Not even a Muslim. But Hisham ibn Amr. He felt that this is not right. So he went and he talked to another one, whom Bani Hashim is their uncles. His name is Zuhair ibn Umayyah. And they went to a third person, his name is Zam'a ibn al-Aswad. Fourth person, Ibn al-Bukhtari. And then he went to a fifth person. 5 people, dear brothers and sisters. All what it took, but organized, working as a team. They went and came in front of the Kaaba, and there is Abu Jahl, the most enemy that who is against breaking this boycott and this sanctions. And one of them, he said, this is something that we never accepted, and we should not, it should not continue. So immediately Abu Jahl jumped on him and he said, you are a liar. Nobody is going to break this sanction. And then a second one of those 5, from a different angle, he said, no, you are the liar. We never accepted this. And then a third person who was standing in a different angle, he said, yes, those 2 are saying the truth. We did not agree to this. And then the 5 people. And then the 5th one said, we are going to cut it. And he entered and he cut that agreement. And Abu Jahl said, this has to be a plot that has been done somewhere else. But he couldn't do anything about it. 5 people were able to break this 3 years of sanction, dear brothers and sisters, against the Muslims and Bani Hashim, just only because they worked with the spirit of a team and a group. This is what our deen is about. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون احسنه. هذا واعلموا ان الله قد امركم بامر بدا بنفسه واثنى بملائكة قدسه. فقال جل من قال ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وابراهيم انك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وابراهيم انك حميد مجيد. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت، وعافنا فيمن عافيت، وتولنا فيمن توليت، وبارك لنا فيما اعطيت. وقنا واصرف عنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت. اللهم لا تدع فينا مقامنا هذا ذنبا الا غفرته، ولا هما الا فرجته، ولا كربا الا نفسته، ولا عسيرا الا يسرته، ولا محتاجا الا كفيته، ولا ولدا الا اصلحته، ولا مظلوما الا ايدته، ولا ظالما جبارا الا قصمته، ولا مريضا الا شفيته، ولا مريضا الا شفيته، ولا مريضا الا شفيته، ولا ميتا الا رحمته، ولا ميتا الا رحمته، ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا لك فيها رضا ولا فيها صلاح الا يسرتها برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما، وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما، ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. عباد الله، ان الله يأمر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم، واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله اكبر. والله على ما تصنعون. واقم الصلاه.